Hello everyone and welcome back guys to more Forza Horizon 4, where today we're here back with more of the unlocking cars here from Season 29. This time out we're heading to the Simplify Then Add Lightness Lotus special event here. The reward is a Lotus 311, it's A-class Lotuses ready for this one. So we are going to be taking out the Evora, yes, a bit of an underrated car in my personal opinion here. But three races, 13 miles, and we will, yeah, like I said, unlock the 311. I do already have this car on Horizon 4, but always nice to have another if needed. This one looks to be done on street scene races, so intrigued to see how well this will go. But yeah, obviously Lotus is an iconic British brand in the world, in the manufacturing world. Then North Coast Rush is going to be the first race of the day. We've got a couple of Esprits, a couple more Evoras, and like always, we will grab a quick photo. Make sure we get all the cars in this shot. That'll take us closer, ever closer, to 100 cars. I'm going to try and get to 200, obviously, for the achievement, and then I'm really not going to worry after that. I don't think there's any more rewards after that on this game. But anyway, yeah, first race of the day then. Let's just see how this car fares here on Forza Horizon 4. Ooh, we've actually got more cars to take a photo of, so we'll quickly do that as well. Don't want to try and do this too much in these races. Next car I unlock is a Portofino, so definitely want to try and bag that if possible. But yeah, intrigued to see how the Evora handles. It's stock at about mid 700 range on this game, so yeah, intrigued to see how, you know, with a few small upgrades that we put on it, pretty much just a couple of little power pieces and obviously just the standard sort of brakes and things like that, as well as a couple of little grip upgrades. Just try and make it a bit better through the corners. Not exactly like it struggles through the corners. You can see very, very planted through there. Gets a little bit loose on the exit, but that's all right. As the top two have already made quite a clear breakaway at the front of the field. As always, Forza, especially the Horizons, very, very power orientated, which unfortunately means for poor cars like Lotus, they normally don't get much of a chance, unless, of course, you're talking some maxed out X-Class specialist weird thing that, for some reason, you can fit a 24-litre V18 in it, because power. Power and low weight and weird grip Forza physics wonders. This game is weird at the best of times, in terms of some of the fastest cars on it. Looks at the 599XX that does 300 miles an hour as well. But yeah, unfortunately, yeah, off my rant, Lotus doesn't really get much of a chance to shine in this game for the most part. I used to rock, actually, a GT1 for online racing, all-wheel drive swapped, but it, yeah, didn't quite have enough to hang in the end when the power tunes really sort of came in and the PI sort of slowly but surely, like, obviously to get people to play the game more and unlock the new cars. They started to make, obviously, all the newer releases just that bit better. And then, unfortunately, yeah, OG cars kind of got nerfed, therefore, accidentally in the process. But anyway, two-thirds of the way through this race, this car, though, feels quite nice in A-Class. I'll be honest, feels nice and planted. It will never win any races online, because it, yeah, simply just doesn't have the poke down the straights. But in a field worth of Lotuses, seems to have enough to hang on in there at the moment as we head in towards the final few corners of this one. Yeah, probably again going to be, I mean, it's fairly similar distance to the BMW trophy that we did last time. See if you missed out on that video. Would recommend going back and checking it out. We unlocked a brand new car in that one, the E92, or at least for me anyway, the E92 GTS, and we drove the BMW M4. Very, very good fun that thing was as well. But anyway, in towards the final couple of corners of the first race of the day, though, a fairly commanding race win in the end. 20 points on the board. We'll take it rather happily indeed. Nice, as always, to just start these championships with a win rather than struggling. You can see Esprits, Evoras, and an Exige seem to be the dominant cars in this championship. I think some of the older motors don't quite have what it takes to hang. As, was that a Porsche that we nearly unlocked? I don't know. Have we not unlocked that as well on this game? Have I not done enough street scene races up to now? I don't really know. Anyway, into race two then. This was actually going to be a circuit race around a very, very small loop on this game. Yeah, perhaps we've got another car that we need to unlock as well here from street scene stuff. I think it was a Porsche of some sort. I'm not going to try and guess and make myself look like a bit of an idiot. But anyway, second race of the day in the little Lotus. Let's try and get another dub on the board, so obviously we can just not have to worry in the final race of the day. See, even where Fusk is quite short, doesn't even struggle with that all too much as well. Obviously, you get him into second gear, the wheel spin sort of goes away, and then really after that, you can just sort of romp away in towards the first couple of corners of the stage. Obviously, we have still got to deal with traffic, and of course, I appear to be the only one that gets screwed by it, as someone flung it out into my path, as this isn't actually a circuit race. It's a race we've done before. Someone else finally gets screwed by traffic as well. Thank you very much. But yeah, no, this one we actually did in the last championship, I think. Last week, even, I should say. We've done this track. I didn't recognise it before then, but it has actually been in the game for a very long time. Perhaps I'm just a bit rusty with Horizon 4 as well. But yeah, we have actually done this track a couple of times beforehand. It turned out I just can't clearly remember it on this game as well as I thought I could. But yeah, so far they've not been the best start to this race, but although the field's still fairly tidy and bunched up as we head in towards the halfway stage. Everyone just trying to work out their own lines. That is not the line to take in towards that corner though. Over the bridge we go. Oh, definitely getting a little bit loose in a couple of places. We'll go to the outside of the defender as there's just driver tiles parked on the apex. I was trying to go for a cutback and it hasn't worked out for us, as now we've got a long, long run up the hill. This is obviously where power is absolutely key, where all the Lotuses will struggle just a little bit. But again, luckily with it being only Lotuses allowed, we can all sort of struggle up the hills with each other. That guy clearly doesn't want to struggle up the hill though, together as we thread the needle. And then yeah, we do still have not long to make progress. Come on. Come on. One third of this race to go. We need to be at least, sort of, I think, fourth. We want to still mathematically wrap up the championship in the final race. So things aren't looking all too brilliant at the moment. Watch out for another defender. Oh, why they're suddenly everywhere. Is there going to be carnage? Oh, God. That was not good. Come on, power. That was not a good line. By myself, one of the Espris has got a horrible run. He's held up one of the other Revoras. So there might be a chance here for just a little bit more. Try and get to the outside. We are about just, only just, going to clutch P3 then at the end of the second race of the day. There is all. The leader almost put it into the back of the car at the final turn. We are really struggling, actually, with some control there. Stick. There, not too sure what that's about. But yeah, we are still leading the championship, though tied at the top. So it looks like it's going to be a repeat of the BMW Championship. And we have unlocked the Hoonigan Porsche as well. We've still actually got a few street scene levels to go on this game, it appears. So maybe I'll have to grind that out at some point as well. But one more race to go then. Whereabouts are we heading? Oh, here we go. This one is up in the hills, so should be good fun once again. Might struggle in the first half in the little Lotus, but hopefully second half we won't need to worry all too much, and we will bag ourselves another 311 on this game. Don't think it's a particularly rare car, don't think it's worth too much, but always nice to have a spare just in case. I was considering going back to try and stockpile some cars on this game once again, but I don't think it's going to be something I'm going to end up doing, in all honesty. Level rank 366. So we're through another one of those as well here today. But yeah, anyway, final race though. We need a dub. Hopefully, just like in the BMW Championship. Then we've had a first and a third. So we will continue, hopefully, with another dub in the final race. That was incredibly close to getting the checkpoint taken away from us. Why are you trying to chuck me at someone's poor Mini? Not really too sure. The AI, yeah, like to play dirty on this game, it appears, at the moment. Though certainly wanted to throw in some blocks, as that guy is just going to be sat right in the way. Luckily, we've got a car with some good sticking power and to get around the outside there as we head up the hill. You can see even more just traffic on the roads. It's the middle of the night. What are people doing? Surely you want to be tucked up in bed rather than trying to avoid Lotus street racing. It's a popular sport. Everyone knows this in the north. I would have thought. Oh, and night goes by where you don't hear the sound of a Lotus tearing past, or 14 Lotuses tearing past your house. I would have thought up there, but anyway, in towards the halfway stage, though. We are already up to fourth at the moment, so we're doing better than the last race, but not perfect at the moment. Come on, what are you doing? Just sat in the way. Down the hill we go. Yeah, I'm definitely got some controller stick, so that's why it's left the throttle wide open a couple of times so far. Like then is a good example. So, not good from... Oh, we're going to have to rewind there. I can just see how this that was going to end up going. Can't afford any major issues. We do need to win this one. We got a good run out onto the final big straightaway. And look at that. You can move across this right at the last moment all you like. Got so much overspeed. We will finally inherit the lead once again in this final race of the day. Get the car nicely tucked in. Final couple of corners, though. And... Ooh. Nicking the wall there through the final turn, but we do hold on, only just, for the championship victory once again there, so rather happy with that. The Lotus 311 will be ours. And there we go, another championship completed here on Forza Horizon 4. If you did enjoy, do make sure you get yourself subscribed as well for more Forza Horizon 4 content coming to the channel, as next time out we'll be unlocking the final car from Summer from Season 29. We're ready to try and unlock the Aston Martin AMR1, a very, very valuable car on this game. One that I would definitely recommend collecting if you can. We'll like the setup. It served us well. It gave us a championship victory at the end of the day. Thank you all so much for watching, and yeah, be back here soon for that final video.